before we get more and more engrossed and involved in the continuing saga of what is playing out now, both in our society and in the Catholic Church. Let me wish all of you, my dear AFI family members and YouTube subscribers, a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. This is Father Bing Arellano, your spiritual director in the Alliance of the Holy Family International Movement. We remember the consoling words of Isaiah chapter 40, verses 3 to 4. The voice of him that cries in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places plain. Then we hear the opening hymn and the Advent Mass reverberating with joy, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lonely exile here until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to you, O Israel. Christmas is a celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ, our Messiah and Savior, whom Mother Mary brought forth into the world. But Christmas this year, 2020, with all that has happened and continues to happen in the world and in the church, may not be as what the Advent hymn calls out, O come Emmanuel and ransom captive Israel. Seemingly, the whole world, from wherever and however you look at it, is in bondage, is shackled and held captive by evil. The spiritual battle between good and evil rages ever more evident these days. And in this very year, as we watch the dark forces descending upon the children of God who continue to valiantly hold forth, defending the Catholic faith with the Blessed Mother at the helm. And I mean, these valiant children of God are the lay people, you, who are now the ones at the very forefront of the battle against Satan and his minions. It is the lay people who are now defending the true Catholic faith, the authentic magisterium, and the living traditions. When the Wuhan virus was released, it shut down the whole world, a deadly pandemic which claimed not only lives and properties by the millions, but it also claimed almost our faith as churches were closed and the celebration of the sacraments prohibited. Economic collapse followed, and many countries to this day are still grappling for survival. With businesses shut down, jobs have been lost, families are hurting with the future uncertain. Then everyone begins to speak of the Great Reset, a political ploy engineered by the elite few to complete their eugenic plan in every country. In the global political arena, democracy has to be outlawed, and the Marxist-Communist agenda has to be set in place. And as we see it forcibly implemented, whether through cheating or any other criminal means, all these evil machinations being brought forth glaringly by the deep state and the deep church, all from the same cohort of the elite few, did not happen overnight. It has been contrived for decades, centuries, since time immemorial, when Lucifer was driven out of heaven and turned his vengeance on God and his children. What we are seeing now playing out in the world is the final battle raging between Satan and the Blessed Mother, from whom he would meet his crushing defeat, because it has already been confirmed, ordained, that in the end, our Blessed Mother will triumph. Her Immaculate Heart will triumph. So, my brothers and sisters, my urgent wish for all of you who are watching this video is this. Look at all these things that are happening in the world and in our church with a critical mind, a deep prayerful disposition, and a firm will not to be confused at any cost by the attempts of Satan's minions to distort the truth and destroy the Catholic faith. As one brave Catholic journalist said it right, their aim is to weaken the faith by raising distortion of the truth in people's minds, raise questions in their minds about the truth, raise doubts, raise sufficient doubt so as to conclude that Jesus is not God. In the end, what has been made evident has been exposed openly in all this chaos that has exploded this year 2020 is the devil's extreme hatred for God, his faithful children, and his Catholic Church, that he will do everything in his power to destroy. Evil is so evident now that you can almost see its face in every person who is not with God. But understand, we are not fighting flesh and blood, as the scripture says. We are fighting against principalities of darkness, that is, the devil. To win this spiritual warfare with the Blessed Mother, we must strike the head, therefore, at the only entry of influence of Satan, which is sin. As sin is the only evil, and the greatest of all evils, as Catechism says in Articles 57 and 58. The cry of St. John that resonates so loudly to us these days is, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." Therefore, make repentance your aim this Christmas, to disarm the power of Satan. That means live in the state of grace at all costs. And Satan is powerless against God, the church, and her faithful children. How? First, make a good confession every week if possible before Christmas. Second, pray the rosary every day as a family. Third, consecrate yourself and your family to the Sacred Heart of Jesus and the Immaculate Heart of Mary by having your home enthroned and wear the brown scapular of Mount Carmel as a sign of your consecration. Fourth, go to Mass every day, if not every Sunday, especially on Christmas Day and New Year's Day. Fifth, make holy hours of adoration, at least an hour a day. Sixth, study the Catechism of the Catholic Church. This is where many Catholics are failing, and that is why, when challenged, many could hardly explain or defend their faith. Catholics who are weak in their catechism possess poor knowledge of the truth that can be easily distorted by fake news and false ideologies like Marxism, Communism, and New Age. I ask all our AFI family members, everyone who has been enthroned, consecrated to the Alliance of the Hearts of Jesus and Mary, to enroll and study by heart the Catechism of the Catholic Church, which we have made and uploaded in this YouTube channel. This is the gift you can give to yourself, to your family, relatives, and friends, especially this Christmas, in these difficult times. This is our AFI movement solution to growing confusion and distortion of the faith. I pray that when the year 2021 begins, all of you who have studied this AFI Catechism course are ready to enter the battle arena to defend the Catholic Church, our faith, against all heresies and attempts of the evil one to destroy family and life. By doing all of these suggestions mentioned above, we will experience this year a deeper and most joyful meaning of Christmas in our lives and our family life as the Emmanuel come to ransom our captive country from Satan. Once again, a blessed Christmas to everyone. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.